Hello everyone, my name is Bharadwaj Bapineni. Today we will be discussing deep work by Carl Newport and why it is so important nowadays. So what is deep work? We'll be seeing here what is deep work and why it is so important nowadays, and how in the history deep work has helped so many scientists and inventors to solve the difficult problems of humanity and become rich and get success and whatnot, everything. So why is this deep work so important? Let's dive in today to see what is deep work and how you can leverage a lot of things by means of deep work. So deep work is professional activities performed in a distraction-free environment that push your cognitive abilities to their limit. These efforts create new value, improve your skill, are hard to replicate. This is the definition of deep work. You are in an undistracted environment. Say for example, Thomas Alva Edison, when discovering the light bulb, is isolated in his environment, which is the Menlo Park in his laboratory, where he is undistracted. No one is there to disturb him. That's where he discovered all the important discoveries that changed the mankind. So that is the type of activity that you need to be doing. That's called deep work. So this is the technique used by almost all people who have achieved something difficult. And the opposite of deep work is shallow work. So what does the hypothesis say? So the ability to perform deep work is becoming increasingly rare, because you see, we are all distracted by the phone we have, the kind of TV shows, movies, Netflix. Wherever you go, there are a lot of distractions that are so tempting that you can't resist. See, even me, I like watching Netflix, but what I do to perform deep work, I isolate myself. I keep my phone in another room so that I am able to do the deep work which is important for my life and for me. So the ability to perform deep work is becoming increasingly rare. At exactly the same time, it's becoming increasingly valuable in our economy. So people who do deep work are people that, you know, are very successful, are people who are very knowledgeable about their field. So as a consequence, the few who cultivate the skill and then make it to the core of their working life will thrive. These are the kind of people who are able to, you know, demand high salary jobs, like doctors, lawyers, physicians. So many people who are able to do the deep work are the ones that are paid a lot of salaries, because they are knowledgeable. So where do they get their knowledge from? They get their knowledge from the deep work they do every day in an isolated environment, in a distraction-free environment. So what is automation? Automation is something that machines do. You see, a lot of jobs in the industries are being automatized by means of robots. Machines are becoming increasingly more and more capable of automating away shallow work. Machines require someone who has done a lot of deep work to program them. For example, say programmers. This is a current scenario playing out in the world of knowledge workers. You see? So there are three groups that will succeed: the highly skilled workers, the superstars, the owners. People with the skills to be able to work with highly complex systems and machines works inside a larger company. The superstars are people with very specific skills. Say for example, a neurosurgeon who has a very specific skill set in an area that are far above most of their field, and generally work alone and on contract for a much higher pay. Say for example, neurosurgeons and nephrologists, neurologists are people who are very specific about their skills and they demand a larger price. These are called the superstars. These are the three kinds of people that will succeed in the next 2 or 3 decades. And the owners, people who invest, people who own a lot of land, or people who are investors, capitalists, and a lot of people like that. Those people, naturally succeed at whatever they do, because they have a lot of capital. And the core abilities, and coming to the two core abilities for thriving in new economy, what are the abilities that you need to have, in to thrive in new economy?
it's the ability to quickly master hard things, you see. It's the ability to think through complex systems. It's the ability to analyze complex information and make things simple. Say for example, you got a trauma case in the emergency department. So how are you going to deal with those complexities? Okay, you need to master the basics and do the deep work required for that trauma treatment. Okay, so the ability to produce at an elite level in terms of both quality and speed. Say for example, in a trauma, in an emergency ward, you need to make decisions in the span of like what, 20 to 30 seconds. So how much of the deep work you need to do in order to understand that complex system? Both of these depend on your ability to do deep work. And again, what is deep work? Deep work is your ability to do the work in an undistracted and distraction-free environment, where you focus on single thing, and you know, ability to learn things at a much deeper level. The main difference between the successful people and normal adults is the ability to master hard things. You see, studying medicine as what I do is a hard thing, but how do you do it? You do deep work daily. For example, say 4 to 5 hours of deep work every day can put you in a much greater position when compared with the people who do shallow work. This is also called high quality work produced equals time spent as well as the intensity of focus. Guys, we need to focus on this one, which is called the intensity of focus. You are spending 8 to 10 hours a day in your home studying while juggling a lot of multiple tasks. So that brings down the intensity. Okay. For example, say another guy is spending just 5 hours and the intensity of his focus, say, is 10. He's doing much deeper work and he's able to learn things much quicker and he'll be able to master hard things very quickly. So there is this term called attention residual. So what is this attentional residual? Say for example, you are switching between a lot of tasks. Say for example, you are reading a book and simultaneously you are checking your phone, and your mom called you and you went to your mom and had a chat with your mom, and you come back and again you start studying. This is where you're doing the mistake. Okay, whenever you focus on something, okay, you leave your attention there. For example, in a 24 hour time period, you have around 100% of the attention. Whenever you dedicate your attention to a lot of things, your attention decreases as the day progresses, or as you spend a lot of time on different things, your attention reduces, and when it comes to the important things, you don't have any more attention to give. So this is called the attention residual. So for example, you wake up every morning and you check your phone, you leave a lot of attention over there. So when switching between tasks, you severely limit your capacity because some of your attention stays with that task, okay? So the more cognitively demanding the two tasks you're switching between, the more residue is left when you switch between them, okay? Leads to you performing poorly on the main most important tasks, yes, as we discussed previously. So deep work is rare, okay? Big trends in business. Say for example, investors are a very intelligent guy. So how do they become more intelligent? It's because they do their deep work. Business as a proxy for productivity. And why is deep work is so meaningful? Because deep work is not just lucrative, but a way to live life well. You see, for example, whenever you're trying to solve problems, if you are in a distracted environment where you can't think through the problems, you are just doing the shallow work. You can't solve the important problems. But on an opposite side, you're doing the deep work. You're undistracted. You went out for a walk undistracted without your phone. You think through the problems and you come up with solution. That's how you do the deep work, and that's how you live. Deep work is not just a technique or a productivity tool. It's a way of life. That's what Carl Newport is intended to say. So what is flow? This is an important concept that we guys need to remember. Flow is a concept designed by Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi. I think he's a Swedish psychologist. He's very famous for his term called flow. Flow is a psychology of optimal experience where you are so focused on the task that you miss the parameter of time and hunger and everything else. So most people assume that relaxation makes them happy, but in reality we are happiest when our body or mind is stretched to its limits in a voluntary effort to accomplish something difficult that's worthwhile. That is called flow. That means, say for example, you spend 8 to 9 hours solving a medical case that you're so interested in that you feel like 8 to 9 hours has quickly moved like 8 to 9 minutes. Deep work is an actively well suited to create flow states. So the rules of the deep work, let's go back, let's move to the rules of the deep work. Say for example, deep work is highly dependent on willpower. So what is willpower? You have a finite amount that becomes depleted as you use it. The key to deep work is then to move beyond willpower and create routines and rituals around performing deep work. So here you will be having these things called Atomic Habits will be a very good book for you guys to read to create systems where you are constantly, you know, doing the deep work. So what is this philosophy of depth philosophy? There are these four kinds of work or deep work. This is one of the monastic philosophy, the bimodal philosophy, the rhythmic philosophy, the journalistic philosophy. Let's dive into this monastic philosophy. Maximizes deep work by minimizing shallow obligations. Cut off from email, cut off from obligations. All your focus goes into what you're working on. This is the monastic philosophy. Say, let's go back to the bimodal philosophy. Time is divided into specific chunks, can last days, months, or years at a time. The rhythmic philosophy, generate a rhythm for your deep work that removes the energy you would need to invest in deciding when and if you're going to deep work. The chain method. So this is the journalistic philosophy. So we need to ritualize this deep work. We need to have a routine that constantly allows us to do the deep work. So how do you do it? Great creative minds think like artists but work like accountants. So deciding where you will work and for how long. See, this where is very important for you to do the deep work. If you're working around your friends, it's not deep work because you're constantly distracted. You're talking, you're doing a lot of things, you're not focused. And how you will work once you start to work? You need to have a clear goal in mind when you start working. You need to know what you're working on and you need to be undistracted. How you will support your work? Okay. So these are the rules that you need to focus. The number one rule is get yourself isolated, okay? So these are the things that you need to focus on. Social media takes out a lot of attention residual. Please delete your Instagram, Facebook and all the social media apps because it is consuming a lot of attention. See, for example, you make this an experiment, ban yourself from social media for 30 days. Don't tell anyone you're doing it, okay? Ask yourself these questions. How are the last 30 days notably better if I had been able to use this service? Shallow work damage is often underestimated and its importance is often overestimated. Schedule every minute of your day. What does this mean? Scheduling, that means you're scheduling your relaxation also, which is very important for you to do deep work again and again. Quality of your depth of activities, pay people to do your shallow work for if you can, fix the schedule for productivity. So these are the things that so this is a book called Deep Work. This will help a lot in terms of your productivity and how you understand complex systems. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos on productivity, neuroscience and habit forming.